Hello, everybody, and welcome to my latest review of His Dark Materials, Season 1, Episode 5, The Lost Boy. So, I've been plowing through these reviews of His Dark Materials, this wonderful show that the BBC have made, and, well, HBO for America. So, the basic plot of this one is as follows. On their journey to the station, Lyra and the Egyptians finally discover what the gobblers have been doing to the missing children. That is, in essence, what is going on in this episode. And this is one of the rare episodes, I think the only episode, where Ruth Wilson does not actually appear as Mrs. Coulter. She does not appear in this episode, which is interesting. It won't surprise you to know that I love this episode, and the fact that she is not in the episode doesn't bother me. This is a fantastic episode. It really is just wonderful. What's also interesting about this episode is the fact that we focus on Will, this boy, Will Parry, who is from the real world, our world, essentially. And we focus on his life. He's taking care of his mother, who is suffering from some kind of medical condition or something. And he's going to school, and he's being bullied, and his father is gone. And there's loads of drama surrounding that. Carlo, the man from the Magisterium, is actually snooping around, and he's following them, and he's stalking them. And he actually talks to Will's mother and tries to get information about Will's father. And she realizes this, and he pretends to be a friend of the father. And so we're seeing the beginnings of Will's story. And of course, Will will become a much more prominent character in season two when Lyra's story and his story converge. But we will see much more of Will as we go along. But it is interesting to get an insight into his personal life before his adventure really begins, or well, at the very start of his adventure. He's played by Amir Wilson, and yeah, he gives a decent performance. The best of him is yet to come, so we'll leave Will out there for a moment. I mean, I don't know what it is, but these episodes just keep getting better. The writing is just superb. The acting is superb. This particular episode, it's quite an emotional episode. It's quite harrowing, actually, because Lyra finds Billy in this abandoned shack or whatever, and he has been stripped from his demon, and he's basically a zombie. He's like a corpse. And sadly, that spoiler alert, Billy dies. Very emotional when Lyra comes back, and then we see Mark Oster completely break down, as you would understand. I mean, she is his mother, for God's sake. I really appreciated that the episode took the time to mourn for Billy, even though Billy's quite a brief character in the story. It was quite hard-hitting. Children are so innocent, and this is what's happening to them. They're stripping them from their demons, and it's wrong. It's basically manslaughter, if you like, or child slaughter in this case. And there's a lovely scene where they're all singing to him as they're burning his body. They're all mourning him, and they're having a memorial for him. They're singing for him. I think Anne-Marie Duff steals the show this time. Her performance is just incredible as the grieving mother, and also how she is still like a mother to Lyra as well, and she's still watching over her. Because at the beginning of the episode, Lyra is reading the alethiometer, and the alethiometer is telling her to go and look into this abandoned place, into this settlement. And it takes a while for Lyra to actually get approved to go there, but she goes with Yurek, who protects her. There's also a lot of great scenes with her and Yurek as well, when he talks about his past and how he was excommunicated from the bears because he killed a bear, even though he wasn't meant to do that. So I really liked the friendship that is brewing between Lyra and Yurek, and seeing how Yurek has become much more hardened, and he's changed, and he does regret what he's done, and he feels like he can trust Lyra, and they are becoming very good friends. One thing I will say about this particular episode is Lee Scoresby, played by Lin-Manuel Miranda. He's good. He doesn't seem to do that much. He's just kind of hanging around with the Egyptians, but it doesn't matter. I mean, he's there to also become closer to Lyra as friends, and I like the conversation they have at the very beginning where he's lying down on his air balloon, and she's walking with him and talking with him, and she's like, "You're a very hard man to like, Mr. Scoresby," which is interesting. But they are very good friends, and he does comfort her when Billy dies, and he tells her that Billy dies, so he's good for the scenes he's in, but he's not in much of the episode, so don't get excited for him. I do think, again, the start of this is a little slow. It does take a bit of time to get going, but once Lyra goes on her side quest, then it does start to really pick up. Yeah, but for the first 20 minutes, they are just kind of walking around. So that's why I stand by my opinion that these episodes could have been 45 minutes each. I just think that would have allowed it to be tighter, because a lot of the episodes do have a couple of pacing issues, but this one, not as much as the previous episodes. I also think visually, this is stunning. Absolutely visually stunning. I've never seen a TV show that looks as visually stunning as this. There is that shot where Lyra's riding on Yurik through the snow. It is a TV budget, so it's not going to look like Hollywood, but for the budget, it looks impressive, actually. It looks really quite good, and I'm amazed that they managed to get it so detailed, and it's the attention to detail that really stands out to me. Another great character moment of this episode is at the very beginning when Father Corum meets Seraphina Pecula, the witch, and I think this might be the first time we've seen her. I can't remember if I've seen her previously to this, but I liked that moment between the two of them. It's a very emotional conversation, how they've had to kind of deal with the loss of their son. That's why Father Corum feels like he can't lose any more children from the Egyptians, and he has to help them. He feels obliged to help them. And it's nice to know that the two characters are still very much in love. And I really thought that was a very tender, sweet moment. John Farr and Mark Oster losing Billy mirrors Father Corum and Seraphina losing their son. Obviously, the two happen at separate times, but I like that the story kind of mirrored in that respect. I mean, this episode is fantastic. It is a really great, emotionally strong episode. And it also ends with Lyra getting captured by the people at Bolvanger. And at the end, she gets brought in to be experimented on in the same way that Billy was. They ask her to strip off. So she takes all her clothes off, so she's naked. And they're examining her. And then she realizes what's going to happen. She's going to be cut from Pan, a demon, and I mean the ending is very dramatic, incredibly dramatic. But, I can't help it, I love this show. It's just really good. Like I said, my one minor criticism would probably be pacing at the start, but I can get over it. It's not too bad. But if I can look past that, then I'm sorry, I can't help it. I think this is the best episode so far. I've got to give this episode a 10 out of 10. I know it may seem like I'm being incredibly generous to this show, but it deserves it. It is so engrossing. I am hooked by this point. It does take like 2 or 3 episodes to get into this show, but once you're into it, there's no turning back. Not for me anyway. Okay, so that's my review of The Lost Boy. So what do you think of this episode? Please comment down below, let me know, and stay tuned next time when I review The Demon Cages. So until next time, I'm Mr. TARDIS 11. See you soon. Bye for now.